Hi, welcome back. I'm Rakesh Naik, and today we are going to discuss about one more algorithmic technique, that is backtracking. So let us start. In our childhood, we have played this kind of game, haven't we? A dog is there and there are roads, and based on these roads we want to take this puppy to his home, right? We have tried this kind of problem during our childhood, is right? Let us try once more. So how it will go? It will start from here. There are two options now, whether he has to go left or he has to go right. Let's try this way. Now the road is blocked. He has to go back. Again, he has to go forward. Again, there are two paths. He has to go left or he has to go right. He has chosen one path. Now the road is blocked. He has to come back. Again, he has to go forward. Again, there are two paths. Again, he has to follow. So like that, the dog is trying to find its path to its home. This is how we are doing backtracking. We are coming to a location. If that particular path is not leading to the solution, then we'll again come back, again try to explore some other path, and we'll discard that path totally. There is no need of discussing about that route where this path is not leading to the solution, right? So we'll say the formal definition. Basically, this backtracking is coined by an American mathematician. His name is D. H. Lehmer in 1950. Basically, what we are doing here is, in this technique, we are searching for a set of solution or optimal solution which satisfies some constraint. It incrementally builds the candidate to the solution and abandons each partial candidate, or we are saying it backtrack, as soon as it determines that the candidate cannot possibly be completed to a valid solution. And backtracking can be applied only for a problem which admits the concept of partial candidate solution and a relatively quick test of whether it can possibly be completed to a valid solution. Now, this is the basic synopsis of backtracking. Now, if you try to relate it to the dog problem, what is happening? The dog is trying to find its path to its home. He don't know which path to go. He is trying a particular path. If the path is blocked, it means that path is not leading to its home. He is coming back to a previous location and again he is carrying forward, right? It means what? He is incrementally trying to build a path to its home, right? So whenever the path is not leading to its home, he is abandoning or he is discarding that path totally. He is not looking after it at all. Okay. And this backtracking is applied whenever there is a concept of partial candidate solution. If you are liking the video, share with your friends. And if you are a first time viewer, kindly subscribe now. Basically, backtracking is faster than your brute force methods, and backtracking is an important tool for solving constant satisfaction problem such as crossword or Sudoku. All these problems we can solve by backtracking. One way of solving the backtracking problem is by exhaustive search. Now, backtracking is a variation of exhaustive search, and where the search is refined by eliminating certain possibilities of the solution. When the solution is not leading to the result, we eliminate that particular path or that particular part of the solution. Basically, backtracking is faster than any exhaustive search. The general method we'll see. Let us say we are having a set of solution. We are saying the solution to be in the form of x1, x2, xn, and where xi is chosen from a finite set S, and we will be having a criteria function p of x1, x2 up to xn is a vector which satisfy P, and sometime we need only the optimal solution. Now, in order to apply backtracking to a specific class or problem, one must provide data P for a particular instance of a problem that is to be solved. Basically, to have this backtracking problem solved, we generally have take 6 procedural parameters, that is root, reset, accept, first, next, and the output. Let us see what are they. When we are saying root, it is the initial partial candidate from where the tree of searching will be starting. And if we'll say P reject P of C, when a partial candidate solution we are rejecting, it is not worth completing searching henceforth. Accept P comma C means we are returning true if the solution C is leading one step at least to the solution. Otherwise, it is not leading to the solution, so we will say the solution to be, it will return false. First P comma C will generate the first extension of the candidate C. Next P comma S generates the next iterative extension of the candidate after the extension S, and output P comma C use the solution C of P as appropriate to application. Now let us see how the algorithm will look like. Backtracking algorithm we are going to see, we are saying BT means backtracking of a particular element P. So if you are starting with the element C, procedure BT of C, then if that element is rejected, then we will simply come out. If the element is accepted, then we will write to the output and we will say that particular element S as first of PC. Now if S is not null, what we will do? Again we will call the procedure BT. Okay, and again we will go to the next element. This is the basic algorithm we will be adopting for any backtracking method. Now, what basically we are doing here? In backtracking method, the solution is traced using depth first search. The decision problem can be solved using backtracking. While making a decision, we are allowed to make bad decisions, and the state space tree is searched until the solution is obtained. And all possible solutions are tried. If the solution is not satisfying the constraint, backtrack and try other solution. Then the applications that we'll be having are Enquin problem, sum ups offset problem, and finding Hamiltonian circle. These are only few. There can be many more applications for this backtracking problem. If you are liking the video, share with your friends, and if you are a first time viewer, kindly subscribe and press the bell button near the subscribe so that you will get the regular updates. Thank you for watching this video till the end. Keep watching, keep learning, and do share with your friends. Thank you.